Hi friends, this is Subrat here, and in this video we are going to discuss about pandas data frame pivot table. So let's start. So we have already seen what is the use of pivot method. So we can use the pivot method to reshape our data frame to a particular index and by using particular column values. So we'll use pivot table to summarize and aggregate our data present inside a data frame object. So pivot method is only used to reshape our data frame, but pivot table is used to summarize and aggregate the data present inside the data frame. So we'll discuss with different examples how we can summarize our data and how we can use some aggregate functions like summation, difference, division, subtraction, multiplication by using the pivot table. So before that, we need to see the full signature of my pivot table method. So here I have mentioned the full signature of the pivot table method. So it takes same as values, index and columns as an argument. Apart from that, it takes also aggregate function agg func as an argument. So the default value of the aggregate function is mean. So if you are using the pivot table and you want to aggregate, by default it is going to aggregated by using the mean value only, and fill value, margin, drop NA, margin names. So these are the some of the arguments that my pivot table is taking. So let us discuss the first example how we can use the pivot table to summarize our data. So here I have a data frame called DF. I have year, month, profit and loss columns. So this pivot method and pivot tables are used whenever your column contains duplicate values. That means you have a repetition of values and you want to aggregate and you want to combine all these values and you want to form a new data frame, then you can use the pivot method or a pivot table. At that time only it is very useful tool that we can use to reshape our data frame object. So here you guys can see 2010 has present many times here, two times. 2011 has present also two times here. 2012 is also present two times. So here I have the repetition of year values. So month value is also repeated, January also repeated here, February is also repeated. So these repeated values you can form as your index values and a column values. So in this case I can make this year column as my index values and my month column as my column values, and the values that you can use can be profit or loss. So let us reshape our data frame by using the pivot table, and we can use some aggregate function to summarize our data. So here as my index I have used year column, as my columns I have used month column, and as my values I have used the profit column. So here as I have used index as my year column, so in place of index the year values is going to come. So here we can see I don't have any repetition of value, index will be unique in nature over here. If you are using pivot or pivot table, the duplicate values will be combined and it will form a single row. So here 2010 has two times, and after using the pivot table 2010 has come only single times. So 2011 also single. So it is just going to combine all those duplicate values and form a single value over here. So here month has also been repeated. So December, February, January, May. So it has combined all those duplicate values and form a new unique month values. So here as we have used values as my profit column, you can see in 2010 January I have 100 rupees profit. In 2010 in January we have how much profit it's showing? It is showing 250 as my profit, because by default the aggregate function is mean value. Suppose you have repetition of rows like this, 2010 January, here also 2010 January. Here I have two times 2010 January row row or record is present inside my data frame, and I just want to aggregate these two rows and form a single row. So by default, the aggregation function is mean value. So 400 plus 100 is 500, and the mean of the two is 250 over here. So here the values are the mean values you are seeing, and wherever the values are not present, it's showing us NaN, not a number. So in this way, you can use the pivot table method to reshape your data frame and to implement some aggregation function. So by seeing this reshaped data frame, someone can say that at the year of 2010 and the month of January, I have 250 rupees profit. And at the year of 2011, in the month of February, I have 550 rupees of profit. So it will be very helpful if you want to aggregate your data and you want to reshape as per your choice, then you can use the pivot table method. So let us see the second example how we can use the pivot table. Suppose this is my data frame. So it is also same as previous, but the order has been changed over here. Here you can see I have 2010 four times over here, and the month is also changing here, 2010 January, and here 2010 February. So here 2011 February and 2011 January. So in this case, if you want to use the pivot table method, then you will get an output like this. So same as index as year and columns as month and values as profit. So if you are using this, you will get a pivot table like this. 2010 February month, I have 550 rupees of profit. So how it is calculating? 2010 February month. So here 2010 February month, 600 plus 500, and the mean is 550 over here. And 2010 January, it is calculating 150 rupees as my mean value. So here I don't have any NaN values, because here 2010 January and 2010 February having its values. As I have only two columns, for these two columns in 2010 I have the values, that's why it is not containing any NaN values. So let us see the different examples. So in case of values argument, you can pass a list also. As in my original data frame, I have both profit and loss as my columns, you can use both as your values column. So if you are using both as the values column and you are passing as a list, then you will get an output like this. Till this, it will be profit, and after that it will be loss. It will create a two different column values over here for February, and February for January and January. This February and January is for loss, and this February and January is for profit. So as many columns also you can pass into my values attribute. So let us use some aggregate function. So by default, the aggregate function is mean value, and you can change this aggregate function of your any choice. So here I have used my aggregate function as sum. So if you are using sum as your aggregate function, then it's going to add those values. So let's see how here 1100 is coming. For 2010 February month, we need to see. So for 2010 February month, you can see 600 plus 500, it is 1100. Let us see one more value. For 2011 January month, let's see. So for 2011 January month, you can see 800 plus 700 is equal to 1500, it's showing. So in this way, you can change the aggregate function of your choice. So here the aggregate function can be product, sum, NN, product, NN, sum, like this. So I'll share this link with you, and you guys can go through all this aggregate function and you can implement this. Let us see one more example. Suppose I have a data frame like this. So this is a normal data frame. I don't have any repetition of values inside each columns. If you are using the pivot table method, let's see what's the output you are getting. Suppose you want to make your D column as your index column and the B column as your column names, and the value column is A column over here. If you are using like this, you will get output like this. As you have used D column your index, so here 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, it's going to come. As you have used the columns as the B column, here 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, it's going to come. So here the value column is A, the values is going to distributed like this. So here I don't have any repetition of values present inside each column, so it is not going to aggregate anything. If you have repetition of values, then it's going to aggregate and it's going to apply the aggregate function. So let us see one more example. So here I have years, month and measurement over here. So here in 2010 I have two measurements. In 2010 January I have two measurements over here, 10 and 20. In 2012 February I have two measurements, 30 and 40. In 2014 March I have two measurements, 50 and 60. Let us apply this pivot table method to this data frame and see what's the output we are getting. So here, as I have repetition of values, 2010 is coming two times and January is also coming two times, then it's going to apply my aggregate function as mean value. So here 20 plus 10 equal to 30 and the mean it's going to come as 15. So here 2012 has come two times, that's why it is going to apply the aggregate function. So here 40 plus 30 equal to 70 and the mean it's going to come as 35. So here 2014 the mean is as 55. So here if you have the repetition of values, then you can apply the pivot table method and you can use some aggregation function of your choice and you can aggregate your data frame and you can summarize it. Using the pivot table method, you can easily summarize your data frame and can find out more insight from your data frame easily. So friends, this is all about how we can use the pivot table method and how we can use the aggregation functions. I hope this concept is clear. If you guys have any doubt regarding this, you can leave a comment under my video. Thank you.